again, Maharaj Amit Prabhuji, Shweta Mataji, please. We can have a darshan of the deities there.
Okay.
And Maharaj, today we are celebrating the Shri Balaram Purnima festival.
Yes.
And we are also celebrating 125th anniversary of Shri Prabhupada, the entire 10 days festival, Maharaj.
Oh.
And we are very fortunate to have you also, Shri Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Your blessing and your mercy in this program, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna devotees, we are very fortunate today to have with us His Holiness Bhakti Vinayavinas Narasimha Swami Maharaj. And we all are very blessed to have Maharaj association in the past as well. And yet another opportunity to hear from Maharaj and to associate and to be purified. So the devotee who has joined today for the first time, who is not familiar with Maharaj, Maharaj is a disciple of Srila Prabhupada. And he got initiated in year 1971 from His Divine Grace in London. And just a year later, he received his second initiation. He has been preaching for over the last now almost now 50 years. And out of those 25 years, Asian countries such as India, Philippines, China, Taiwan, Singapore, Hong Kong, Malaysia, and Thailand. And through his years of preaching, he has given countless souls practical guidance and deep inspiration. And Maharaj also received the highest order of initiation, which is Sannyasa Ashram, Sannyasa Diksha in 1994 from His Holiness Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj. And that did not mean much of change in his lifestyle, since Maharaj has always been strict in his sadhana. And whoever gets to know Maharaj admires and respects his sincere and faithful practices of chanting the holy names of the Lord. He truly walks the talk. Maharaj has been teaching with the Mayapur Institute since its inception. And in Kanhaiyadesh, we have been very much blessed with Maharaj association time and again. And once again, today we are welcoming Maharaj all together. So let's welcome Maharaj by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. His Holiness Bhakti Vinayavinas Narasimha Swami Maharaj ki jai.
Om Ajnana Timarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine Vanchakaupata Rubyascha Kripa Sindhu Baye Vacha Patitanam Pavane Bhyo Vaishnavi Bhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So today is the auspicious Balaram Purnima in the month of Shravan. Lord Balaram appears some 8 days before the appearance of Lord Sri Krishna, which comes, of course, on the Janmashtami, which we are all anxiously awaiting for. Are we having translation tonight?
Yes, Maharaj, because we have Hindi speaking duty as well, Maharaj.
Yes.
Aaj hum sab Shri Balaram Purnima ka utsav jo aata hai Shravan mahine mein aur Bhagwan Shri Krishna Janmashtami ke utsav ke pehle to hum sab wo utsav ke bhav mein rehte hain aur Janmashtami bas aane hi wale hai kuch samay mein.
So, in order to properly honor the Janmashtami, it's very important that we also have a festival in honor of Lord Balaram, who is the older brother of Lord Sri Krishna.
So, Janmashtami ka utsav manane ke purv ye bahut mahatvapurna hai ki Bhagwan Balaram, jo ki uske kuch din pehle, jaise aaj Balaram Purnima ke din prakat hue the, unka utsav manana.
Just as we cannot worship Lord Chaitanya on his own without Lord Nityananda, Lord Chaitanya will not be happy. So in the same way, if we try to worship Lord Krishna without Lord Balaram, we will not be successful.
जैसे चतन महाप्रभु प्रसन्न नहीं होंगे अगर हम नित्यानंद प्रभु की सेवा नहीं करते हैं, उसी प्रकार भगवान श्री कृष्ण भी प्रसन्न नहीं होंगे अगर हम बलराम जी की सेवा नहीं करते।
And we should understand Lord Balaram is not different from Lord Sri Krishna. Lord Balaram is also the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The only difference between the two is in the color. Of course, Lord Krishna is Shyam color and Balaram is white in color.
तो भगवान श्री कृष्ण और बलराम में कोई भेद नहीं है, केवल एक ही अंतर है उनके बीच में, केवल उनके जो कांति है शरीर की उसका ही भेद है, एक श्याम कांति में है और एक स्वर्ण जो श्वेत कांति में है।
I have to warn you, Prabhu, we're having a power problem here tonight. I've had the power go on and off. We just went in a blackout here. Oh, it's just come back on. But anyway, be prepared.
Okay, Maharaj.
This is India. You know India.
Yes, Maharaj. But we're able to hear your voice, Maharaj. That's so purifying, Maharaj.
So, Lord Balaram is in the mood of the servant of Lord Krishna. He enjoys to be the servant. His purpose in coming with Lord Krishna is to serve Lord Krishna.
तो बलराम जी परम पुरुषोत्तम भगवान वो भी हैं, लेकिन वो सेवक भगवान हैं, और वो भगवान श्री कृष्ण की सेवा करने के उद्देश्य से ही प्रकट हुए
हैं। Actually, Lord Balaram serves Lord Krishna in all the rasas. Sometimes he will be the servant of Krishna. Sometimes they will be like friends. Sometimes Lord Balaram will be like his father, and Lord Balaram also appears as an Angamanjari, and as an Angamanjari, he enjoys also the conjugal rasa with Lord Krishna.
तो सभी रस में बलराम जी भगवान कृष्ण की सेवा करते हैं, शांत भाव में भी उनका विस्तार हो करके, पादुका हो करके, उसके बाद दास्य भाव में भी सेवा करते हैं, साक्य भाव में उनके मित्र बन करके, वात्सल्य भाव में उनसे बड़े भ्राता के रूप में आकर के, और अनंग मंजरी के रूप में वो माधुर रस का भी आस्वादन कराते हैं भगवान को।
Lord Balaram expands himself in different forms simply for the service of Krishna. There are 10 items which are personally used by Lord Krishna, and they're all considered to be expansions of Lord Balaram.
तो बलराम जी अपने आप को विस्तारित करते हैं भगवान श्री कृष्ण की सेवा के लिए। ऐसा बताया गया है कि 10 ऐसे वस्तु हैं जो भगवान की सेवा के लिए आवश्यक हैं, जिसको कि बलराम जी अपने आप को विस्तारित करते हैं।
These items include things like Lord Krishna's shoes, Lord Krishna's bed, Lord Krishna's seat or asana, and then the cushions which Lord Krishna uses. Then there's all. Do you want to translate? Go ahead.
जैसे कि भगवान की पादुका, उनके बिस्तर, उनके बैठने के लिए आसन और जो कुशन होते हैं, ये सभी भगवान बलराम जी विस्तारित करते हैं अपने आप
को। Then also Lord Krishna's ornaments and Lord Krishna's dress and the chamara which is used to fan Lord Krishna, they're all considered to be expansions of Lord Krishna, Lord Balaram, for the service of Lord Krishna.
और जैसे कि भगवान के लिए आभूषण, उनके लिए जो चामर है, उनके जो वस्त्र हैं, ये सब भी बलराम जी अपने आप को प्रस्तावित करते हैं भगवान के लिए।
And the brahmana thread around Lord Krishna, that is also Lord Balaram.
और जो जनेऊ पहनते हैं भगवान, वो भी बलराम जी की अपने आप को प्रस्तावित करते हैं।
So there are actually 10 items which Lord Balaram expands, personal expansions, simply for the direct service of Lord Krishna. And then Lord Balaram also appears in 5 different forms to assist Lord Krishna in the work of creation.
इस प्रकार से 10 इस वस्तुओं में भगवान बलराम जी अपने आप को विस्तारित करते हैं भगवान कृष्ण की सेवा के लिए। इसके अतिरिक्त 5 रूपों में अपने आप को विस्तारित करते हैं इस सृष्टि की रचना के लिए।
Right, 5 forms are Sankarshan, Anantashesha, then Karanudakshayi Vishnu or Mahavishnu, Garbhudakshayi Vishnu and Shirudakshayi Vishnu. These are all expansions of Lord Balaram.
तो ये पांच विस्तार हैं भगवान बलराम के सृष्टि में अनंत शेष संकर्षण अनंत शेष महाविष्णु काड़ोक्षाय विष्णु जिसको कहते हैं हम लोग और गर्भोदक्षाय विष्णु और क्षीरोदक्षाय विष्णु.
So we see Lord Balaram assisting not only in the Leela of Lord Krishna, but also in the Srishti Tattva, in the work of creation for the material worlds. Lord Balaram is also playing a major role.
So we see that not only the Bhagavan in his Leela, but also in the Srishti Tattva, Balaram Ji plays a very important role.
The different avatars which appear in the world, they come through Shirodakshay Vishnu.
जो विभिन्न अवतार आते हैं इस भौतिक जगत में वो क्षीरोदक्षाय विष्णु के द्वारा ही आते हैं.
So the das avatars, Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narsingh, they're all coming through Kshirodakshay Vishnu, who is an expansion of Lord Balaram. So they are expansions of an expansion of Lord Balaram.
जैसे कि मत्स्य अवतार, कुर्म अवतार, वराह अवतार, नरसिंह अवतार, ये जो अवतार हैं, ये भी क्षीरोदक्षाय विष्णु के द्वारा अर्थात ये बलराम जी के विस्तार हैं.
And Lord Anantashesha, he is a wonderful devotee. He's holding up the different universes on his hoods, and each of the universes are just like mustard seeds resting on a hood.
और अनंत शेष जो है वो अपने फन के ऊपर वो सभी ब्रह्मांडों को धारण किए हैं जैसे कि सरसों के दाने के बराबर.
So we can just imagine the size of Lord Ananta Shesha, how huge and how powerful he must be that he can support a whole universe on his hood just like one mustard seed.
तो इससे हम उनके रूप की कल्पना कर सकते हैं कितना विशाल रूप होगा उनका विशाल काय रूप कि इतने बड़े ब्रह्मांड जो उनके फन के ऊपर है वो एक सरसों के दाने के बराबर लगते हैं.
And everyone who speaks Hari Katha, they need the blessings of Lord Anantashesha. Lord Anantashesha is very, very powerful. He's always speaking the Katha. He's always glorifying the Supreme Lord.
और जो भी भगवान की कथा करते हैं उनको अनंत शेष का आशीर्वाद चाहिए क्योंकि अनंत शेष अनंत काल से भगवान का कृष्ण का गुणगान कर रहे हैं अपने अनंत मुख से.
It is said, since the beginning of the creation, Lord Anantashesha began reciting the glories of the Lord, and he has an unlimited number of hoods. So from each of his hoods there's a mouth, and each mouth is speaking the different pastimes and glories of the Lord. But they never repeat each other, and they are never exhausted.
अनादिकाल से आदि इस ब्रह्मांड के आदिकाल से ही अनंत शेष जी जो है वो अपने अनंत मुख से जो उनके फन है उसमें मुख हैं उनसे वो भगवान का गुणगान कर रहे हैं और कोई भी एक मुख दूसरे मुख वाले गुणगान से समानता नहीं उससे भिन्न गुणगान कर रहे हैं और अभी तक वो गुणगान करते हुए थके नहीं.
So since time immemorial they're speaking and glorifying the Lord. And there's no end. They've never come to any end. It is said that the four Kumaras, they heard Srimad Bhagavatam from Lord Anantashesha. So the four Kumaras, they have that's Nambarka Sampradaya, right? Coming from the four Kumaras. And the initiator of that Sampradaya is Lord Anantashesha.
तो महाराज बता रहे कि अनंत शेष जी अनादिकाल से कथा करते आ रहे हैं और अभी तक अंत नहीं हो रही कथा की और उनसे ही चारों जो चतुष्कुमार हैं उन्होंने उनसे दीक्षा प्राप्त किया मतलब उनसे ही वो श्रवण किए भगवान की कथा के बारे में जिससे कि ये निम्बार्क संप्रदाय जो है वो वहाँ से शुरू होती है कुमारों से.
So Lord Balaram, his at the name give, oh, well, first of all, he appears as the seventh child in the womb of Devaki. And his purpose in coming is to prepare the womb for Lord Krishna, who comes as the eighth child in the womb of Devaki.
So Bhagavan Balaram ji, वो सातवें पुत्र के रूप में देवकी गर्भ में आते हैं, और उनके देवकी के गर्भ में आने का जो मुख्य उद्देश्य है वो भगवान श्री कृष्ण के लिए उस स्थान को तैयार करना.
The first six children were the Sadgarbhas. They were originally the sons of Marichi, and they were cursed. They committed an offense. As a result, they were born in the family. They were born as the sons of Kalanimi, and as the sons of Kalanimi, they were. Their grandfather was Hiranyakashipu.
तो ये उसके पहले सडगर्भ आए थे जो कि सडगर्भ मरीचि के पुत्र थे. उन्होंने अपराध किया था तो कालनेमी के पुत्र के रूप में जो कालनेमी जिनके जो हैं दादा हिरण्यकश्यपु थे.
So as the sons of Kalanemi, they worshipped Lord Brahma for a benediction that they would not be killed by any demigod or any human. And when Hiranyakashipu found out, he was very angry that they did this independently of him.
So उन्होंने ब्रह्मा जी से ये वरदान मांगा कि मुझे किसी भी जो नर असुर हैं देवतागण हैं उनके द्वारा मेरा मृत्यु नहीं हो. जब इस बात की जानकारी हिरण्यकश्यप को हुई तो बड़े क्रोधित हुए कि मुझसे स्वतंत्र होकर के कैसे इस प्रकार से उन्होंने वरदान मांगा.
And so as a punishment, Hiranyakashipu cursed them that they would take birth in the womb of Devaki and they would be killed by their father.
और उन्होंने इस प्रकार से उनको वरदान दिया कि वो श्राप दिया हिरण्यकश्यपु ने कि वो लोग देवकी के पुत्र के रूप में आएंगे और उनके पिता के द्वारा ही उनकी मृत्यु होगी.
And their father Kalanemi took birth as Kamsa. Kalanemi was killed by Vishnu. Next life he came as Kamsa. So as Kamsa, he killed his own sons. He didn't know, of course, they were his sons, but his sons had taken birth in the womb of Devaki, and one after another, Kamsa came and killed these. And these six children were the Sadgarbhas, who had been his own sons in the previous birth.
Kalanemi hi baad mein unka Vishnu ke dwara unka vadh hua, भगवान विष्णु के द्वारा. फिर वो कंस के रूप में उत्तरित होते हैं, कंस के रूप में वो जन्म लेते हैं, और कंस के रूप में जन्म लेके पश्चात उनके ही पुत्र जो हैं वो सडगर्भ के रूप में आते हैं, वो नहीं जानते हैं, और पिता के रूप में वो उनका वध करते हैं.
So after they were killed by Kams, then these Sadgarbhas they went down to Sutala Loka where Bali Maharaj reside, and they resided on the same planet with Bali Maharaj.
और कंस के द्वारा वध होने पर सतगर्भ जो सुतल लोक में जा करके और जहाँ पर बलि महाराज रहते हैं उनके साथ में उसी लोक में वास करते हैं.
Yes, Sutala Loka is a subterranean heavenly planet. It's below the earth. It's in the lower regions of the universe, but it's very opulent.
तो सुतल लोक में जो सप्तरिणी जो वहाँ पर बिल्कुल स्वर्ग के जैसा जिसको बिल स्वर्ग कहा जाता है उस प्रकार से उसे जो है धरती के नीचे लेकिन बहुत ही ऐश्वर्यवान जगह है वो.
So these six sons they resided there for some time until it happened that Vasudeva and Devaki were freed from the prison house of Kamsa and Kamsa had been killed. And then at that time Devaki, she had heard how Lord Krishna had actually saved the life or brought his guru's son back from death, that his guru's son Sandipani Muni, his son had died and Lord Krishna had brought him back. And so when Devaki heard about this, she asked Lord Krishna that you please bring back your six brothers.
और उसके पश्चात जब देवकी को ज्ञात होता है कि किस प्रकार से कृष्ण ने अपने गुरु संदीपनी मुनि के पुत्र को वापस ले आए थे मृत्यु के पश्चात भी, उसके बाद ये जानते हुए उन्होंने विनती की कि कृपा करके मेरे जो सठ पुत्र थे उनको भी आप वापस ले आइए.
So Lord Krishna went to Sutala Loka and brought the six sons back. And then Devaki, she wanted to feed her breast milk. So first she fed Krishna her breast milk. And after Krishna had taken the breast milk of Devaki, then the Sadgarbhas came and they also sucked the breasts of Devaki. And in this way they got Krishna Prasadam. And in this way they became qualified, they could go to heaven, they could go back to their heavenly, their position in the higher planets, in the heavenly planets.
तो उसके पश्चात भगवान श्री कृष्ण जाते हैं स्वर्ग लोक में देवकी जी के आग्रह पर और वहां से सर्गर्भों को लेकर आते हैं वहां पर और देवकी माता उनको स्तन का पान कराना चाहती थी. सबसे पहले भगवान श्री कृष्ण ने स्तन का पान किया, उसके पश्चात सर्गर्भों ने पान किया और कृष्ण का महाप्रसाद ग्रहण करने के द्वारा वो अपने वास्तविक स्थिति में आ गए और जहाँ पर वो स्थित थे पहले ऊपर के लोकों में अपने अपने स्थानों पर वापस चले गए.
So then Lord Balaram comes as the seventh child in the womb of Devaki and he makes arrangements for Lord Krishna because he knows Lord Krishna is going to come in the future. He wants everything to be nice. He makes nice arrangements and he puts a nice bed there. We said Lord Balaram's expansion is a bed. That bed is Ananta Shesha. So one of the expansions of Lord Balaram is Ananta Shesha became a bed there in the womb of Devaki. And when Lord Krishna appeared there, then he could rest on that bed by the arrangement of Lord Balaram.
और तब सातवें पुत्र के रूप में बलराम जी देवकी जी के घर में आते हैं. जैसा पहले हमने सुना महाराज से कि वो भगवान श्री कृष्ण के लिए उस स्थान को उत्तम बनाने के लिए वहाँ पर आए थे और उनके ही विस्तार अनंत शेष वो भगवान के बिस्तर बनते हैं जिससे कि भगवान वहाँ पर आके काम कर सके.
We should understand why Lord Balaram comes as the older brother. Previously in Ram Lila, Balaram came as Lakshmana, and Lakshman was the younger brother of Lord Ram. But as the younger brother, he had a lot of difficulty in trying to serve his older brother. Lord Ram would not allow him to give him a lot of luxury or to make his life very easy. Lord Rama said, no, we're in the forest, I should do austerity.
तमें समझना चाहिए कि क्यों भगवान बलराम जो है वो बड़े भ्राता के रूप में आए हैं यहाँ पर भगवान श्री कृष्ण के. पहले वाले लीला में वो भगवान श्री राम के छोटे भ्राता के रूप में लक्ष्मण जी के रूप में आए थे और वहाँ पर उनको बहुत कुछ जो उनकी इच्छा थी करने की सेवा करने की वो नहीं कर पाते थे भगवान को आराम देने के लिए. जैसे क्योंकि भगवान श्री राम जी ने कहा कि नहीं हम वन में हैं और यहाँ पर हमको तपस्या करनी चाहिए, कोई आराम की आवश्यकता नहीं है.
So Lord Rama was always chastising and complaining to Lakshman, and Lakshman was becoming discouraged, and it came like that, that Lakshman decided next incarnation I will not come as the younger brother, next incarnation I am coming as the older brother.
तो भगवान श्री रामचंद्र जी उनको कई बार इस प्रकार से उनको समझाते थे, कभी कभी डांटते भी थे. तो ये देख करके उनको लगा कि मैं पूर्ण रूप से सेवा नहीं कर पा रहा हूँ भगवान की छोटे भाई के होने के नाते, तो इसलिए अब मैं बड़े भ्राता के रूप में आऊंगा, यहाँ पर मैं जो सेवा करना चाहूंगा वो कर पाऊंगा, इसलिए वो बलराम जी के रूप में आते हैं.
So although Lord Balarama is the older brother, still he has the mood of being the servant of Lord Krishna, and his only mission is wherever Krishna goes, he will go with them and he'll be the servant of Lord Krishna.
तो हालांकि वो बड़े भ्राता हैं, लेकिन हमेशा सेवक के रूप में हैं. जहाँ जहाँ कृष्ण जाते हैं वहाँ वो उनकी सेवा करना चाहते हैं.
So Lord Balaram, he is, we said he was in the womb of Devaki, but then he was transferred from the womb of Devaki to the womb of Rohini by the arrangement of Yoga Maya. Yoga Maya came under the order of Lord Krishna. Yoga Maya came and brought Balaram out from Devaki's womb and placed her in the womb of Rohini. Rohini was another wife of Vasudeva, and Rohini was already staying at the home of Nanda Maharaj in Gokul. So Vasudeva wanted his wife Rohini to stay at the home of Nanda Maharaj for her safety because Kamsa was persecuting people. So he wanted his wife to be safe, and he knew in the home of Nanda Maharaj she would be safe there.
तो बलराम जी जब देवकी जी के घर में आए तो योग माया के द्वारा उनको वहाँ से स्थानांतरित किया गया रोहिणी जी के घर में. रोहिणी जी वसुदेव की दूसरी पत्नी हैं जो गोकुल में रहती हैं, क्योंकि कंस के भय के कारण उनको गोकुल में ही वसुदेव ने छोड़ रखा था नंद बाबा के पास.
So when Balaram was transferred, he'd been in the womb of Devaki for 7 months. And when he was transferred to the womb of Rohini, then they thought, oh, Rohini's had a miscarriage. So they thought the seventh child was a miscarriage. But actually it was Yogamaya transferring Balaram to the womb of Rohini. So Lord Balaram was there for 7 months, and then he was in the womb of Rohini for another 7 months before he took birth. And so it was like 14 months he spent in the womb waiting for the pastimes of Lord Krishna.
तो 7 महीने तक वो देवकी जी के गर्भ में थे, उसके बाद वो योग माया के द्वारा उनको स्थानांतरित किया गया रोहिणी जी के गर्भ में, और जब 7 महीने में वो गर्भ स्थानांतरित किया गया तो सबको समाचार ऐसा लगा कि ये इनका गर्भपात हो गया है देवकी जी का। लेकिन वहाँ से आने के बाद 7 महीने यहाँ पर भी रोहिणी जी के गर्भ में बलराम जी थे, उसके पश्चात वो प्रकट हुए। तो महाराज कह रहे हैं कि उनको 14 महीने तक गर्भ में रहना पड़ा,
So with the birth of Lord Krishna and Lord Balaram, Vasudeva wanted to arrange the name-giving ceremony, and he asked Gargacharya to go there and to do that name-giving ceremony for the two boys. So when Gargacharya came there, then he told how Lord Balaram, he gave him three names. The first name was Rama, which means pleasing to everyone. And the second name was Sankarshan, because Sankarshan means bringing together, joining together, that he'd come from the one family to the other family, bringing the family of Vasudeva and Devaki to the family of Nanda and Yashoda and Rohini. And so Sankarshan, bringing the different families together. And he was also, the third name of Lord Balaram was Balabhadra. Bala meaning great strength. Lord Balaram is very strong.
So Vasudev ji, Krishna aur Balaram ke janam hone ke pashchat unhone Gargacharya se ye vinti ki ki ja karke wo gokul mein unka naam kar samskar kare. उन्होंने बलराम जी को तीन नाम दिए। पहला नाम रामा, सबको आनंद प्रदान करेंगे। दूसरा संकर्षण, संकर्षण का मतलब कर्षण, जो आकर्षण होंगे, दो परिवार दो जगह को आकर्षित करेंगे, जैसे वहां से गर्भ से आकर के इस गर्भ में आना। और तीसरा उनको नाम दिया उन्होंने बलभद्र, जो बहुत ही बलशाली होंगे।
वन ऑफ द ग्रेट बेनिफिट्स वी कैन गेट फ्रॉम लॉर्ड बलराम इज स्ट्रेंथ, spiritual strength, because we have to fight against the material energy, and the material energy is very powerful. But if we take shelter of Lord Balaram, he can give us spiritual strength and we can conquer over the Maya.
एक आशीर्वाद जो हम लोग प्राप्त कर सकते हैं भगवान बलराम से वो है आध्यात्मिक बल, क्योंकि हम सब को इस माया से युद्ध करने के लिए माया बहुत बलशाली है, हमको बहुत बल की आवश्यकता होगी, और ये बल हमको आध्यात्मिक बल वो बलराम जी की कृपा से प्राप्त हो सकता है।
So Lord Balaram appears in the womb of Rohini, and so he's known as Rohini Nandan, one who gives pleasure to Rohini. Also, that's another name of Lord Balaram, but at the time of the birth, Gargacharya had given these three names, Rama, Sankarshan, and Balabhadra.
तो गुरुणी जी के गर्भ में आए जिसमें का नाम रोहिणी नंदन भी है, लेकिन ये तीन नाम जो है गर्गाचार्य दिया था उनको, रामा, संकर्षण और बलभद्र।
And Lord Balaram with Lord Krishna, they grew up together in the home of Nanda Maharaj. Nanda Maharaj is a Vaishya, so they were with the cows. And as they grew up, they went out into the forest every day to take the cows, to bring the calves and cows into the forest. Lord Krishna and Lord Balaram, every day they'd go together into the forest, they'd have wonderful pastimes. And they would also, sometimes they would meet different demons, and they would have to confront the demons. And some would be killed by Lord Krishna, some would be killed by Lord Balaram.
तो नंद बाबा के यहाँ पर, चूंकि उनका कार्य था गाँव की सेवा और कृषि, तो यहाँ पर ही दोनों लोग कृष्ण और बलराम वहाँ पर ही बड़े हुए, पले बढ़े। वहाँ पर जब वो जाते थे गाय को चराने के लिए कई बार खेतों में और इस प्रकार से, तो कई बार उन लोग को असुरों का भी सामना करना पड़ता था और उनके साथ में युद्ध करना पड़ता था, उनको पराजित करते थे। किसी असुर को कृष्ण उनका वध करते थे और कई असुरों का वध बलराम जी करते थे।
One day, the cowherd boys were in the forest, and the cowherd boys came to Krishna and Balaram, and they told them how there's a very nice forest nearby called Talavan. And in this Talavan forest, there's wonderful fruit trees, and the fruits are very sweet there. They have nice tala fruits and other fruits. It's very wonderful. Only problem is there's some demons there. And this demon, Denuka, has taken the form of a jackass, and he won't allow anybody to go there. Even the birds can't go there. So they asked Lord Krishna, can you help us? Could you and Balaram go there and kill these demons so we can also, everybody else can enjoy the fruits?
तो एक बार वहाँ पर भगवान श्री कृष्ण बलराम जब अपने ग्वाल बाल मित्रों के साथ में खेल रहे थे, तो कुछ मित्र आके बोले कि कृष्ण बलराम बड़ी भूख लगी है, सामने बहुत अच्छा तालवन है, वहाँ पर बहुत अच्छे फल लगे हुए हैं, बेल के फल, तो क्या वहाँ पर जाकर के हम लोग फल प्राप्त कर सकते हैं? क्योंकि मैंने सुना है कि वहाँ पर एक असुर जो है धेनुकासुर के नाम से, वो किसी को भी वहाँ पर आने नहीं देते, यहाँ तक कि पक्षी भी वहाँ पर उड़ नहीं सकते, लेकिन आप लोग तो बहुत बलशाली हो, क्या हमको वो फल खाने को मिल सकता है?
So our acharyas explain how these demons are all representing different anarthas and different bad habits and faults which have to be removed. And when Lord Krishna kills them, and when Lord Balaram kills them, they're removing these obstacles, they're removing these bad anarthas from us.
तो आचार्यगण कहते हैं कि जितने भी असुर आए हैं वृंदावन में, वो एक एक अनर्थ को प्रस्तुत करते हैं और उसका प्रतिनिधित्व करते हैं, और भगवान कृष्ण और भगवान बलराम उनका वध करते हैं, अर्थात उनकी कृपा से ही इन अनर्थों की निवृत्ति हो सकती है, अनर्थों को दूर कर सकते हैं।
Lord Balaram is especially good in removing the anartha of Hridaya Durbhavyam, the weakness of the heart. And that weakness of the heart manifests in bad habits and faults, like fault finding and being envious of others and desire for position and respect and just quarreling and not being patient. These kind of things.
तो भगवान बलराम जो है वो जो अनर्थ को दूर करते हैं, विशेष रूप से वो हृदय दौर्बल्यता, इसका अर्थ है कि दूसरों में दोष ढूंढना, इतने कमजोर हृदय से होना कि दूसरों में दोष ढूंढना, दूसरों के प्रति ईर्ष्या का भाव रखना, पूजा लाभ प्रतिष्ठा की चेष्टा करना, दूसरों के प्रति विनम्र नहीं होना और उपद्रव उनके साथ में कुछ हमेशा कुछ कलह करना, इस प्रकार के अनर्थ।
So by the mercy of Lord Balaram, we can remove these anarthas, this Hridaya Durbhavyam, all these bad habits which are there due to this anartha, they can all be removed by the mercy of Lord Balaram. So this today, very special day, we're taking shelter of Lord Balaram and we're remembering him, how he went there into the forest of Talavan. And when Denukasura demon heard, because when Lord Balaram came in that forest, he saw the fruits, so he shook a tree and some of the fruits, they fell to the ground. And when they fell to the ground, they made a crashing sound. And so Denukasura was alerted and he came running in an angry mood and he charged at Lord Balaram. But Lord Balaram very cleverly grabbed hold of his hind legs and whirled him around with great speed. The demon gave up his life and Lord Balaram threw him into the top of the trees there.
तो इस प्रकार से बलराम जी की कृपा से हम लोग हृदय दौर्बल्यता इसको दूर कर सकते हैं, और आज के दिवस पर बलराम पूर्णिमा पर हम लोग को इस प्रकार की प्रार्थना से भगवान बलराम जी की शरण ग्रहण करनी चाहिए। तो यहाँ पर बलराम जी जब उनके मित्रों ने अनुरोध किया तो वो आए वहाँ पर तालवन में, और वहाँ पर जब वृक्ष को हिलाए तो कुछ फल जो है वो गिरे नीचे। जैसे ही फल नीचे गिरे उनकी आवाज़ से धेनुकासुर वो सावधान हो गए और वो दौड़ करके आते हैं और बलराम जी पर प्रहार करना चाहते हैं, लेकिन बलराम जी ने बड़ी चतुराई से उनके पैर को पकड़ करके और बहुत चेर से घुमा करके उनको ऊपर फेंका।
Another demon killed by Lord Balaram was Pralamba. Pralamba came disguised as a cowherd boy. Because these demons were so cunning, they could change their form and they would disguise themselves to look just like cowherd boys. So this Pralamba came in the dress of a cowherd boy. So Lord Krishna immediately could understand he was not one of the cowherd boys. But anyway, he said, anyway, let's have a game. He said, we'll make sides, and whoever wins, then they can ride on the back of the loser. So Pralambasura thought that this Krishna is very powerful. I don't think I can defeat him. I will start with Lord Balaram first. Let me take Lord Balaram first. I think I can deal with him. And so Pralamba was matched against Balaram, and Lord Balaram won. And so Pralamba was happy because he got Balaram on his back. And when Balaram got on his back, then he went running away with Balaram on his back.
इस प्रकार से धनुकासुर का वध किया भगवान बलराम जी ने, और दूसरा असुर जिनका वध किया वो है प्रलंबासुर। प्रलंबासुर अपने आप को एक बाल के रूप में अपना रूप बदल करके आए थे। महाराज ने बताया कि असुर इतने चतुर हुआ करते थे, इतने वो मायावी थे कि अपने आप को किसी भी रूप में बदल करके आते थे। तो यहाँ पर वो ग्वाल बाल के रूप में आए, और जब एक बार सभी ग्वाल बाल कृष्ण बलराम के साथ में खेल खेल रहे थे, ऐसा खेल कि जो हारेंगे उनको जीतने वाले को अपने कंधे पर बिठा के लेके जाना होगा। तो उसने सोचा कि अगर मैं कृष्ण को बिठाऊंगा तो कृष्ण तो बहुत बलवान है, ऐसा सुना है उन्होंने असुर का वध किया है, तो मैं बलराम को उठाने का प्रयास कर सकता हूँ, उनको लेके मैं दूर जाके उनका वध करूँगा पहले। इस प्रकार की चेतना से वो खेले और बलराम जी जीत गए। तो बलराम को अपने कंधे पर बिठा करके वो जंगल में दूर भाग रहे थे।
So Pralamba is running with Balaram on his back, but Lord Balaram is no ordinary person, and Lord Balaram in his form of Anantashesha holds up the universe. So Lord Balaram became very heavy. And Pralambasura, he could not carry, Balaram is so heavy, he was like carrying Mount Meru on his back. And Pralamba had to reveal his own form as a Rakshasa. He became a huge, big Rakshasa. And when Lord Balaram saw that, then Lord Balaram smashed his skull with his fist and killed him.
So Balaram ji jab ja rahe the, Balaram ji to anant shesh hain, unke kandhe par baithe hue hain. जब उनको ज्ञात हुआ कि ये मुझे कहीं ऐसे स्थान पर लेके जाने का प्रयास कर रहा है, वो समझ गया कि ये तो कोई असुर है, और उसने अपना रूप भी प्रकट करना शुरू किया। तो अनंत शेष का भार बढ़ता गया, उन्होंने अपना भार बढ़ाना शुरू किया, और तब वो असुर भी अपने वास्तविक स्वरूप में आकर के उनको कुछ कष्ट पहुँचाने का प्रयास किया। उससे पहले ही बलराम जी ने उनको एक मुट्ठी का प्रहार करके उनको धराशायी कर दिया।
So Lord Balaram does not tolerate people trying to be deceitful and cheating like this Pralamba disguising himself like a cowherd boy.
To Balram ji aisa bhi bilkul unko priya nahi hai ki koi apne aap ko badal karke dwand mein aur is prakar ka vyavhar kare ki dikhaye kuch aur andar kuch aur mithyachari jaise ki Pralamba sun kar rahe the.
Another person Lord Balaram killed was the brother-in-law of Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna's first wife was Rukmini, and she had a brother named Rukmi. Now Rukmi had had a number of problems, he had a number of disputes with Lord Krishna, but Lord Krishna had not killed him. At one point Lord Krishna had cut his hair and shaved his beard, but he'd never killed him because he was his brother-in-law.
और उसके पश्चात बलराम जी ने रुक्मिणी का भी वध किया। रुक्मिणी जो है वो रुक्मिणी के भगवान जो श्री कृष्ण के पहली पत्नी रुक्मिणी हैं उनके भाई हैं, भ्राता हैं, और वो सदैव कृष्ण में कुछ न कुछ दोष जोड़ा करते थे और उनके प्रति बहुत ही उनके अंदर ईर्ष्या का भाव था, द्वेष का भाव था। भगवान कृष्ण ने उनका वध नहीं किया, हालांकि वो उनके दाढ़ी और बाल को एक बार उनका अपमान करने के लिए बना दिया था, लेकिन वो हमेशा अपमान करते जा रहे थे।
So it happened, there was a marriage ceremony arranged. After some time, there was a marriage ceremony arranged between the grandson of Krishna and Rukmini and the relative, the grandson of Rukmi. So there was a big wedding, and maybe there was a big wedding arranged anyway, and Krishna and Rukmini came, and all the family members, and Lord Balaram also came. And everything was arranged at the place of Rukmi, at his place. So when they came there after the wedding, then Rukmi challenged Lord Balaram to a game of dice. And they had a game of dice. In the first game of dice, Lord Balaram lost. The Rukmi won. But then the second game, Lord Balaram won. But Rukmi wouldn't admit that he was defeated. And he said, no, no, no. And he was arguing. He said, no, I'm the winner. I'm the winner. And there was another king of Kasi there. And he said, yes. He said, Rukmi is the winner. But then a voice from the sky spoke and said, no, Balaram is the winner. So they had a third game. And in the third game, again, the same thing happened. Balaram won. And Rukmi wouldn't admit it. He wouldn't agree that he had lost. And then he said to Lord Balaram, he insulted him. He said that you may be very good at taking care of cows, but you don't know anything about dice. Dice is a game for Kshatriyas, not for you people. You're Vaishya. You should take care of cows. So that was an insulting remark. And Lord Balaram became angry and he decided to kill Rukmi.
तो ये उस प्रकार उस समय की घटना है जब विवाह के पश्चात और बहुत समय के पश्चात जब भगवान श्री कृष्ण रुक्मिणी के जो पौत्र थे और उनका विवाह रुक्मिणी की पौत्री के साथ में जब तय हुआ, वहाँ पर गए लोग, विवाह का आयोजन किया, बहुत धूमधाम से विवाह चल रहा था। विवाह के पश्चात रुक्मिणी ने बलराम जी और सबको जो है वो जूत क्रीड़ा के लिए उत्साहित किए खेलने के लिए वहाँ पर। तो जब जूत क्रीड़ा हुआ तो पहली बार जब हुआ पासे का गेम, पासे का खेल, तो उसमें जो है रुक्मिणी जीत गए। दूसरी बार जब हुआ उसमें बलराम जी जीत गए, लेकिन रुक्मिणी उसको मारने को तैयार नहीं हो रहे थे। वहाँ के मित्रों के जो थे काशीराज, उन्होंने बोला कि हाँ नहीं, रुक्मिणी जीत गए। लेकिन तभी ऊपर से भविष्यवाणी हुई आकाश से, आकाशवाणी कि ये तो बलराम जी जीते हैं। लेकिन फिर भी रुक्मिणी नहीं मान रहे थे। फिर तिबारा पासा फेंका गया, उसमें भी बलराम जी जीत गए। इस बार भी रुक्मिणी नहीं मान रहे थे। वो कह रहे थे कि नहीं, आपको नहीं आता खेलना, आप तो वैश्य हो, आप लोग केवल गाय चला सकते हो, लेकिन आपको ये क्षत्रियों का खेल खेलना नहीं आता। इस प्रकार से वो अपमान कर रहे थे।
So when Rukmi killed, when Balaram killed Rukmi, Lord Krishna did not congratulate him. He didn't say anything because he knew that Rukmi was the brother of Rukmini, who was his wife. So if he said anything to congratulate Balaram, then Rukmini would not be pleased. And if he said anything to criticize Balaram, Balaram would not be pleased. So Lord Krishna just kept quiet on the death of his brother-in-law.
और तब भगवान बलराम ने उनका वध कर दिया वहीं पर, और भगवान श्री कृष्ण ने कुछ भी नहीं बोला, न तो उनकी आलोचना की और न ही उनकी प्रशंसा की। क्योंकि प्रशंसा करते तो रुक्मिणी उनकी जो पत्नी थी वो नाराज हो जाती, और अगर आलोचना करते तो भगवान बलराम को अच्छा नहीं लगता शायद। ये सोच करके भगवान श्री कृष्ण ने, वो बिल्कुल उदासीन थे और कुछ भी नहीं किया।
But you should understand, Lord Balaram in killing Rukmi, he was doing it as a service for Lord Krishna, because he thought this Rukmi had been offensive to Lord Krishna. He had not done, he was a nasty person. He was always envious and he was always giving trouble to the devotees, and he had even insulted Lord Krishna. Therefore, Balaram had no hesitation in killing him.
तो हमें समझना होगा, महाराज कह रहे हैं कि बलराम जी ने ये सेवा की भगवान श्री कृष्ण के प्रति, और तब उनका वध किया, क्योंकि रुक्मिणी जो है वो बहुत भगवान के प्रति अपराध करते जा रहे थे, भगवान श्री कृष्ण के प्रति, और अपराधों की उनकी जो संख्या बहुत बढ़ चुकी थी, इसीलिए उस अपराध से मुक्त करने के लिए उनका उन्होंने वध किया।
Lord Balaram has two weapons which he has. One is the plow, and his name is, another name of Balaram is Haladara, the carrier of the plow, and another weapon which he has is the club. Lord Balaram was very expert in fighting with the club, and his student was Duryodhan. Duryodhan had learned to use the club from Lord Balaram.
बलराम जी दो शस्त्र धारण करते हैं, एक तो हल, इसलिए उनका एक नाम हलधर भी है, और दूसरा गदा। और दुर्योधन जो गदा में वो भी निपुण थे, उन्होंने शिक्षा बलराम जी से ही ग्रहण की।
It happened at the end of the Kurukshetra war, there was a battle between Bhim and Duryodhan. Lord Balaram told them not to fight. He said there won't be any result. He said, because Bhim is stronger than you, and Duryodhan, you're more skillful than Bhim. So you won't be able to, no one will be able to win. I don't think you should fight. It's not, but they were so hateful and spiteful to each other, they had to fight. And so it happened, Bhim fought with Duryodhan, and of course Lord Krishna told Bhim eventually that you hit him below the belt, and in this way you kill him. And this is how Bhim defeated Duryodhan.
Sorry.
Go ahead.
तो कुरुक्षेत्र के युद्ध में जब युद्ध हो रहा था, तो उस समय बलराम जी ने कहा था कि युद्ध मत करिए आप लोग, लेकिन जब दुर्योधन और भीम के बीच में होना था, तो ने कहा था कि मैं किसी का भी पक्षपात नहीं लूंगा, पक्ष नहीं करूंगा मैं, इसलिए वो युद्ध से बाहर चले गए थे। और फिर भगवान कृष्ण की योजना के अनुसार भीम और दुर्योधन दोनों ही युद्ध में बड़े निपुण थे, गदा युद्ध में, और युद्ध को टाल नहीं सके, ये तो होना ही था, इसलिए भगवान कृष्ण के आदेश के अनुसार भीम जी ने उनके जांग के नीचे प्रहार करके और दुर्योधन का वध कर दिया।
So we may wonder, why would Lord Balaram be so friendly with Duryodhan that he taught him to use the club? But we should understand, this was the cheating potency of Lord Balaram, because Duryodhan was not a devotee. He did not, therefore he didn't get the real mercy of Lord Balaram, which is to become a devotee of Lord Krishna. Balaram taught him to use the club. That's just something material, mundane, a military art. But he didn't give him his real mercy, which is to bring him to Krishna consciousness, to make him a devotee, surrendered to Lord Krishna.
महाराज बहुत महत्वपूर्ण बात बता रहे हैं कि लोग कहते हैं कि बलराम जी को क्यों भगवान बलराम जी ने क्यों दुर्योधन को अपना शिष्य बनाया, तो महाराज कह रहे हैं कि वो उनका जो ठगने की जो शक्ति है भगवान की, उसके द्वारा उन्होंने इसको इस कार्य को संपादित किया, क्योंकि दुर्योधन को उनसे केवल एक कला सीखनी थी, वो उनके वास्तविक शिष्य नहीं बनना चाहते थे, इसलिए बलराम जी ने खाली उनको ये कला सिखाई, ये युद्ध की कला, सैन्य की कला, लेकिन उनकी वास्तविक कृपा तो तब होती है जबकि वो जीवात्मा भगवान श्री कृष्ण के शरण ले ले और कृष्ण भावना भावित हो जाए, तो दुर्योधन वो नहीं चाहते थे, इसलिए भगवान ने बलराम ने उनके ऊपर वो कृपा नहीं की, वो खाली एक कला सीखना चाहते थे, उनको कला सिखा दिया।
Another interesting pastime which took place involving Duryodhan and Lord Balaram happened when Samba, one of the sons of Lord Krishna, and his mother is Jambavati. Samba wanted a wife, and he heard how Duryodhan had a nice daughter named Lakshmana, and she was having a swayamvar where she was going to pick her husband. So many kings had come there because she was a very attractive woman, and many kings wanted her for a wife. So Samba came there also, and Samba thought, she will never pick me. So he thought, I will have to kidnap her myself. So Samba went, and Samba just picked her up and then went off with her. And so it was quite a disturbance to everyone there. All the Kurus, the heads of the Kuru, the heads of the family, they were all Kurus. They were very disturbed. Duryodhan and Bhima and Karna and others. So they decided, we will have to catch this boy, Samba, and give him a good lesson. We won't kill him, but let's capture him and put him in prison. So they went after him, and there was a great fight. Nasamba was also a Maharati, and so they had a good fight. And they kept, but they outnumbered him, and they captured Samba and put him in prison.
तो दूसरी जो घटना है यहाँ पर बताई गई जो लीला है बलराम जी और दुर्योधन के बीच में भगवान श्री कृष्ण और जामवती के जो पुत्र थे सांबा और दुर्योधन की पुत्री लक्ष्मणा तो लक्ष्मणा जो थी वो बहुत गुणवती थी और बहुत आकर्षक भी थी तो उनके लिए सभी राजा लोग जो हैं उससे विवाह करना चाहते थे और सांबा को भी विचार आया कि मैं भी जा करके विवाह का प्रस्ताव चूँकि अगर विवाह मुझे नहीं भी बोलेंगी तो मैं उनका अपहरण कर लूँगा तो इस प्रकार से जाकर के उन्होंने वहाँ पर उनका अपहरण किया लेकिन तभी इन लोगों ने दुर्योधन और सभी कुरु ने उनको पकड़ लिया और सोचा कि ठीक है हम इनका अगर वध नहीं भी करेंगे लेकिन कम से कम इनको एक कड़ा दंड हम देंगे एक इनको ऐसा पाठ सिखाएंगे कि ऐसा कभी भविष्य में नहीं करेंगे तो सभी कुरु लोग मिल करके उन्होंने उनको बंदी बना लिया
So, news came to Dwarka, and when the people in Dwarka heard the news, they thought, this is war. That the Kurus, they've taken Samba and put him in prison. And so the Kurus, headed by Lord Krishna, the Yadus in Dwarka, headed by Lord Krishna, they were thinking to go there and do battle with the Kurus. But Lord Balaram interfered, and Lord Balaram said, no, let me go there, I will talk to them. And I will say, let's see if we can settle up the disagreement peacefully. So they agreed, let Balaram go. And Balaram went there with some great sages like Uddhava. They accompanied him. And they all came there to Hastinapur to meet with the Kurus.
So, jaise hi samachar Dwarka mein mila, Bhagwan Shri Krishna, unke sabhi senapati, सभी सैनिक सब तैयार हो गए कि हम लोग जा करके युद्ध करेंगे ये तो युद्ध की स्थिति आ गई है हम जाके आक्रमण करेंगे कौरवों पर लेकिन तभी बलराम जी आ गए उन्होंने कहा कि नहीं मैं जाता हूँ मैं जाके वार्तालाप करूँगा और वार्तालाप से इस मामले को सुलझा दूंगा युद्ध की आवश्यकता नहीं होगी तो बलराम जी ने कुछ संतों को लेकर जैसे कि उद्धव और इन लोग को लेकर के वो यहाँ पर आए हस्तिनापुर में
So when Lord Balaram came there, the Kurus were very happy. They had a very nice relationship with Balaram. Duryodhan liked Balaram very much. He had taught him how to use the club. So they gave him a good reception. And so then they inquired why Balaram had come. And then they said, Balaram said, I've come to get Samba. I know you've arrested the son of Lord Krishna. And that he's taken Lakshmana, the daughter of Duryodhan, for his wife. So you should free them. I want to take them back to Dwarka. So then they became angry. Duryodhan and some of the other Kurus, they said, oh, listen to him. He's telling us what to do. He thinks he's our master. These people are like the shoes, but they want to put themselves on our head. They were not happy at all. And they did not agree.
But जैसे ही भगवान बलराम वहाँ पर पहुँचे दुर्योधन और बाकी लोग आकर के उनका स्वागत किए क्योंकि दुर्योधन के वो गुरु हैं सैन्य शिक्षा में इस प्रकार से वो सभी का बहुत सम्मान करते थे बलराम जी का सभी लोग वहाँ पर कुलों में और सम्मान उनका स्वागत करने के पश्चात जब वार्तालाप पुनः शुरू हुई तो बलराम ने कहा कि मैं तो यहाँ पर आया हूँ सांबा को लेने के लिए सांबा को आप लोग मुझे दे दीजिए मैं लेके जाऊँगा तो ये देख करके कुलों को बहुत क्रोध आ गया उनको उन्होंने बोला कि आप लोग जो हैं यादव लोग अब इतना आपका वो बढ़ चुका है साहस कि आप यहाँ पर आए हैं मुझे धमकी देने के लिए और आप लोग तो चढ़ गए पादुआ के जैसे हैं और अभी आप हमारे सर पर बैठना चाहते हैं इस प्रकार से कह के अपमान करना शुरू किया
So Lord Balaram, when he heard them speak like that, he said, when you give people good instruction and they cannot take the good instruction, then you have to use a stick. We have to resort to violence. So Lord Balaram then picked up his plow. He said, just like animals, he said, they cannot understand good instruction. You have to use the stick or the whip to beat them, to get them to do what you want. So he said, so in the same way, I will teach you a lesson. And Lord Balaram picked up his plow and he began to drag the Hastinapur palace into the Yamuna River.
तब बलराम जी ने जब देखा कि इस प्रकार से वार्तालाप कर रहे हैं, इस प्रकार से और अपराध करते जा रहे हैं, वो समझ गए कि अब उन्होंने कहा कि अब जिसको निर्देश देना चाहिए, जो निर्देश देने से नहीं समझते हैं, उनको फिर उनके ऊपर छड़ी लेके प्रहार करना होता है। और उन्होंने फिर क्या किया, उन्होंने समझ गए कि ये लोग इससे नहीं समझेंगे तो इनको अभियुक्त करना पड़ेगा। उन्होंने अपना हल लिया और हल से पूरे महल को, जहाँ पर पूरे कौरव विराजमान थे, उनको ले करके और उसको खींचते हुए यमुना में डुबाने के लिए तैयार हो गए, यज्ञ लेके जाने लगे।
So when the Kauravas, when they saw their palace falling into the Yamuna River, then they immediately changed and they pleaded to Lord Balaram, "Oh, please wait, just wait. We're bringing Samba just now. We will bring his wife. Just please wait, please. Do not drag the palace into the Yamuna. Please." And so then Balaram said, "All right, go, you bring them." And they went, they brought Samba and they brought Lakshman and they brought a big dowry. And Lord Balaram took them all back to Dwarka.
जैसे ही सबने देखा कि अरे ये तो पूरा पूरा महल, हम सब पूरा राज भी जाके यमुना में डूब जाएंगे उनके हल के द्वारा खींचते हुए, तो सभी लोग आ गए, सबने उनसे क्षमा याचना शुरू कर दी, उनके चरणों पर गिर गए, कहे कि नहीं, आप हम लेके आ रहे हैं सांबा को, लक्ष्मणा को आप लेके जाइए, हम कोई युद्ध नहीं करेंगे, हमसे बहुत त्रुटि हो गई। बलराम ने कहा ठीक है, उनको लेके आओ, तब मैं यहाँ से जाऊँगा, तभी छोड़ूंगा आप लोग को। जैसे वो गए, लेके आए सांबा को, लक्ष्मणा को, अच्छे से उनको विवाह संपन्न किया, बहुत दहेज दिया और तब वो द्वारका की ओर प्रस्थान किए।
So Lord Balaram carrying the plow is very significant. Just like when you're going to grow, you want to cultivate crops, you first of all plow the field. So Lord Balaram, he's the original guru and he has a plow. He's plowing the field, he's preparing the field to plant the seed of devotion in the hearts of the living entities, to plant the seed of bhakti in the heart of the conditioned souls.
तो उनका हल लेकर चलना, हल धारण करना बहुत महत्वपूर्ण उसकी उपयोगिता है। जैसे कोई कुछ उगाना चाहते हैं तो सबसे पहले उस खेत को जोतते हैं, उस खेत को बीज के रोपने के लायक बनाते हैं, उसी प्रकार आदि गुरु के रूप में भगवान बलराम सबके हृदय में उस हल के द्वारा उनके हृदय, जो कठोर हृदय है, उसको उस उपयोग बनाते हैं जहाँ पर कि भक्ति का जो बीज है उसको रोपा जा सके।
So the spiritual master, we said he is the representative of Lord Balaram. Just as by the mercy of the spiritual master, we get the seed of devotion, he plants the seed. We say, Brahmanda Brahmite Kunyo Bhogyavan Jeev Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Lata Bij. So by the mercy of the spiritual master, we get the seed of devotion planted in the heart. So that is Lord Balaram. He is giving that bhakti, he is giving that seed of devotion. And the plow is necessary. It prepares the ground for putting in that seed of devotion.
तो आध्यात्मिक गुरु बलराम जी के प्रतिनिधि होते हैं और वो उस प्रकार से हृदय को उस प्रकार से बनाते हैं, जोत करके, जहाँ पर कि उस बीज को सींचा जा सकता है, बीज को रोपा जा सकता है। जैसा बताया गया चरितामृतम में कि कौन वो भाग्यवान जीव है पूरे ब्रह्मांड में जिनको गुरु और कृष्ण की कृपा से वो भक्ति लता बीज प्राप्त होती है, तो ये बलराम जी कृपा से हमको वो भक्ति लता बीज प्राप्त होती है उनके प्रतिनिधि गुरु के द्वारा।
So on this auspicious day of Balaram Purnima, we pray to Lord Balaram, please help us, give us the strength, give us spiritual strength, help us to remove the anarthas, and help us that we can purify our heart so that we can properly worship Lord Krishna on the Janmashtami day.
So, आज के दिवस पर महाराज कह रहे हैं कि हम सबको प्रार्थना करनी चाहिए बलराम जी से, कृपा करके आप हमको आध्यात्मिक बल प्रदान करें जिससे हम माया से युद्ध कर सके, और आप हमारे पर कृपा करें जिससे कि हम अनर्थों को दूर कर सके और हमारे हृदय में शुद्धि हो, हृदय से सभी अनर्थों की निवृत्ति हो जाए, जिससे कि हम भगवान श्री कृष्ण जन्माष्टमी आने वाले हैं उनका स्वागत कर सकें।
Another pastime of Lord Balaram came in Naimasharanya forest. That Lord Balaram didn't want to take part in Kurukshetra war, so he went on pilgrimage. And he came to Naimisharanya, and all the great sages there, they honored him when he came. They all respected, they stood up or offered obeisances. Everyone respected him except for one person, Romaharshan Sutta. And Romaharshan Sutta was seated on the high seat. So because he was on the high seat, he'd been chosen to speak. So he thought he didn't have to respect Lord Balaram.
तो जो और एक लीला है भगवान बलराम की कि वो जब युद्ध चल रहा था कुरुक्षेत्र का तो उस समय वो तीर्थ यात्रा पे गए थे और उसी दौरान जब वो नैमिषारण्य में प्रवेश किए तो वहाँ पर सभी लोग बैठे कथा का श्रवण करने वाले थे. सभी लोगों ने उठ करके उनका सम्मान किया उस सभा में, लेकिन जो व्यास आसन पर बैठे थे रोमहर्षण सूत वो अपने स्थान से नहीं उठे.
So Lord Balaram was not pleased. He considered this situation and he considered that he'd appeared to establish religious principles, and he saw this Romaharshan Sutta, although he was a disciple of Vyasadeva, he was not qualified to sit on the Vyasasan. So Lord Balaram took a kusha grass and pierced his heart and killed him.
तो भगवान बलराम जी बड़े अप्रसन्न थे. वो समझ गए कि इनके मन में अहंकार आ गया है, क्योंकि ये तो यहाँ पर व्यास जी के शिष्य हैं और इनको सबका प्रतिनिधित्व करना है, इनको अपने आचरण को सिखाना है, लेकिन ये आचरण उचित नहीं है. तो वहाँ से कुछ ग्रास उठा करके और उनका वध कर दिया.
So when Lord Balaram killed him, all the sages were shocked, and they told Lord Balaram, they said, this is very bad, that, you know, he's a brahmana, you've killed him. And we had given him a blessing that he'd have a long life.
तो सभी जो वहाँ पर उपस्थित थे, सभी लोग साधु लोगों कहे कि आपने उनका वध कर दिया, हम सब ने तो उनको आशीर्वाद दिया था कि वो लंबा जीवन व्यतीत करेंगे, ब्राह्मण थे वो और आपने उनका वध कर दिया.
So then Lord Balaram said, well, I'll bring him back to life if you want. But they said, no, no, you're the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You're supremely independent. We don't want to tell you what to do, but we'd given him a blessing of a long life. So please make some arrangement to settle that. So Lord Balaram said, well, he has a son. Let the son take that benediction. So in this way, the son of Romaharshan Sutta, Sutta Goswami, got the benediction and he became the speaker in place of his father. Hare Krishna.
Yes, yes, Maharaj.
Everything okay?
Maharaj, you told me. Yeah, Maharaj. Little bit disturbance was there. I can understand, Maharaj. So, तब उसके पश्चात बलराम जी ने फिर ये सोचा. उन्होंने कहा कि ठीक है, आप लोग चाहते हैं तो मैं इनको पुनर्जीवित कर सकता हूँ. तो साधु ने कहा कि नहीं नहीं, आप तो परम पुरुषोत्तम भगवान हैं, आप स्वराट हैं, आप जो उचित समझे वो करें. केवल हमने इनको लंबी आयु का वरदान दिया है, उसको पूर्ण करने के लिए कोई योजना करें आप. तो बलराम ने कहा कि उनका जो पुत्र है उसको हम ये वरदान दे देते हैं, और तब उसके पश्चात वहाँ पर उस सूत गोस्वामी को बिठाते हैं.
So we see Lord Balaram is very strict. But when he comes in the Kali Yuga, he comes as Lord Nityananda. And as Lord Nityananda, he's very merciful.
Balaram ji, dekhte hain ki bahut hi wo kathor hai, aisa lagta hai. Lekin jab wahi Bhagwan is Kali Yuga mein Nityananda Prabhu ke roop mein aate hain, to bahut dayalu hai.
Prabhupada told us that the mercy of Lord Nityananda is unlimited.
रूपा जी कहते हैं कि नित्यानंद प्रभु की कृपा असीमित है.
And is considered the spiritual master is representative of Lord Nityananda. So we have to be very merciful and we have to distribute Krishna consciousness to everyone.
और वो कहते हैं कि आध्यात्मिक गुरु वो बहुत ही दयालु, वो श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु के प्रतिनिधि करते हैं, इसीलिए हम सभी को बहुत कृपा करके सभी को ये कृष्ण भावनामृत हरि नाम बांटना चाहिए.
Okay, so should I stop now or should Is there any questions?
Thank you so much, Maharaj. We have taken much of your time, Maharaj, and it's now more than 10 in India. Past 10, maybe 10 or 10, 15. But we're very grateful, Maharaj. You covered the entire pastime of Lord Balaram and all the important incidents Maharaj covered, and so many wonderful lessons also we learned, Maharaj, from your talk. So we are very grateful to you, Maharaj. Maharaj, if you have a time, can we take, Maharaj, one or two questions, Maharaj?
Please, yeah.
तो भक्तों से विनती है, अगर किसी को कोई जिज्ञासा या प्रश्न है तो हमारा से ले सकते हैं. बहुत सुंदर रूप से महाराज ने आज के विषय वस्तु को बताया. आप अपने हाथ खड़े कर सकते हैं. महाराज, एज यू मेंशन,
yes, I see some hands up.
Yes, Maharaj, I'm just unmuting them, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, why? Maharaj, Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Hare
Krishna. Maharaj, why Balaram, Bhagavan Balaram's weapon is hull, I mean plow? He could have any other weapons, no? Why plow?
What's that? But I didn't get the whole.
Maharaj's question is why he is carrying plow. Plow is as a weapon. Why not any other? Why especially plow?
Well, I explained that. I explained about the plow that's used for the field. The body is like a field, and you have to prepare the ground for planting the bhakti, the seed of devotion. So the plow is very significant. Lord Balaram is like the farmer. He's plowing the field, he's preparing the field to plant the seeds. But these seeds are not ordinary seeds, these are the seeds of devotion. So Lord Balaram has plows like that to put the seed of devotion in our hearts. Lord Balaram also used the plough to bring the Yamuna. When he'd been drinking Varuni, he told the Yamuna to come closer, and she didn't come. So Lord Balaram took his plough and said, I'll break the Yamuna and make you little streams. And when Lord Balaram began to break the Yamuna into little streams, then the Yamuna came and fell at his feet and begged forgiveness.
कह रहे हैं कि भगवान बलराम ने अपने हल से एक बार यमुना जी को भी इस प्रकार से भयभीत किया था जब वो वरुणी का सेवन कर रहे थे कि आप हमारे पास में नहीं आएंगी तो मैं आपको भी समाप्त कर दूंगा, आपको दो भाव विभाजित कर दूंगा. तो यमुना उनके डर से भयभीत होकर उनके समीप आ गई थी, ऐसा वर्णन बताया गया. महाराज, यू मेंशन अबाउट द दुर्योधन एंड बलराम जी रिलेशनशिप, दैट हाउ द चीटिंग पोटेंसी ऑफ बलराम वाज शोन दैट इन पास्ट टाइम. Because he taught him that military science, but not the real mercy.
Yes.
And where in the case of Prabhu, that he was going door to door and begging everyone to take the real mercy. So Maharaj, when we understand this pastimes, and we also understand, as you mentioned, that when we approach the Balaram Yonitan Prabhu, then our expectations should be very clear that it should not be any mixed or any other thing than Krishna consciousness. Right, Maharaj?
Yes, definitely. Yes.
So, Maharaj, So Maharaj, when we approach Balaramji, because we see when Lord, the same Lord comes in the form of Balaram, so we more of his pastime where he's killing the anarthas. But when it comes to the, for example, in case of this Rom Harshan Sut Maharaj, what? His dealing with Rom Harshan Sut was sometime devotee, they asked that why it was so harsh. Because that was not a very big mistake in one sense, but his dealing with Rom Harshan Sut was very harsh. On the other hand, Nityananda Prabhu, Jagai Madhai, who hated him and who was so, I mean, in all the sense, they were so degraded. But even though he wanted to save them and he wanted to give that mercy to them. So how we understand this mercy, Maharaj, of Balramji, and in case when he's killing Rom Harsan Chuta, and where he's protecting the Jagai and Madhai.
Yes, we have to understand that Rom Harsan Chuta, it was quite a big offense, you know, that Lord Balaram understood the heart of this Rom Harsan Chuta, that he was not properly devoted. He did not have, it wasn't that he just neglected to offer offenses, but the mentality was not there. He just didn't have a good mentality towards Lord Balaram. He was thinking, I'm speaking, and he's coming here, this Balaram's coming here, disturbing everything. He didn't give any respect at all. So it was quite a serious offense, particularly in the previous yuga. And he's already honored and he's sitting on a big seat. And so it was quite a serious offense. And Lord Balaram understood that this person is not actually qualified. So Lord Balaram comes to protect the people, to give protection from all the bad teachers, the evil teachers. And so, you know, when somebody's teaching, if they're not properly qualified, then it's a great insult. It's very bad because they're cheating. And so this Roma Harshan was actually deceiving. He was deceitful. He was posing himself like the big devotee, like the big guru, but he was not at all. And so Lord Balaram decided they had to remove him. But in Kali Yuga, it's a very different state of affairs. You see, previous yuga, there was still some varnashram there. There was still, you know, the Vedic culture was something was there, some traces of it were there. It was coming to the end. Kali Yuga was just beginning. But now it's much different. And 500 years ago when Lord Nityananda came also, it was quite different. So Lord Nityananda he had to give mercy. In the Dwapara Yuga, he used the Kusha grass to pierce the heart. But in the Kali Yuga, the Kusha grass was put in the mouth, and he would fall at the feet of the people and beg them to chant the holy name. So the same Kusha grass was used in a very different way.
Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you so much, Maharaj. I'm hearing for the first time this Kusha grass analogy, Maharaj. Thank you so much. Maharaj, one question, Maharaj, more. Maharaj, as we hear that, Maharaj, that Guru is Sakshat Haritvana Samasta Sastra, that we should respect our spiritual master as the Lord Himself. And today also we heard from you, Maharaj, that how the spiritual master is representative of Balramji or Nityananda Prabhu. So, do we understand that, Maharaj, we should consider our spiritual master as Lord Nityananda or as Lord Balram?
No. Representative. He's the representative of Lord Nityananda or Lord Balaram.
So Maharaj, when we say Sakshat Haritvana Samasta Sastra, we should consider our spiritual master, we should respect him as Lord.
Yes. We may give respect as the Lord, but at the same time we know that he's different from the Lord. One and different, right? Our philosophy is achincha bheda bheda tattva. So he's one with the Lord, but at the same time he's different from the Lord. Whatever respect we offer to the Guru, Guru has to offer to his Guru. It's not for him. It's for him to give to his Guru. Guru is
so Maharaj, that respect, when we give respect as... So Maharaj, that Lord is Lord Balram or Nityananda Prabhu, that we can, Maharaj, this is what we can understand, Maharaj?
Yes, Lord Nityananda, Lord Balaram, they are the Adi Guru. They are the original Guru, right? The line of spiritual teacher. They are the original guru, and they are passing on this message. They're showing us the mode of service to Lord Krishna. And from Lord Nityananda, we see the mode of service to Lord Chaitanya. So we learn from them how to serve. Although they themselves are the Supreme Lord, they are Sakshad, and we are learning from them how to serve, how we should serve the Supreme Lord. But not that we are the Supreme Lord.
Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you so much, Maharaj. I'm very grateful to you, Maharaj.
Particularly in our ISKCON society, you know, we have the founder Acharya, Srila Prabhupada. So Srila Prabhupada is the founder, and all the other gurus, the disciples, and like, they are all serving Srila Prabhupada. And the purpose of initiation in ISKCON is to connect us to Srila Prabhupada and to the line of the cyclic succession. Yeah. And so it's a very special arrangement in ISKCON that the gurus, although they give initiation and we accept disciples, actually they're not really our disciples, but they belong to the society, and we take initiation into the society of ISKCON. And the ISKCON society connects us to the founder Acharya and to the line of the cyclic succession. So it's a very unique, special arrangement. Other institutions, you know, they have the guru, and the guru is like God. But in ISKCON, it's a little different. Yes, Maharaji, you have a question?
Just a small clarification, Maharaj. We were talking about Rama Harshna Sutta. Was he born as a Brahman, or as his name indicates, was he born to a Sutta? I mean, a Shudra?
Yeah, well, we learn from in the Krishna book I read that he was mixed birth. The father was a Kshatriya, mother was a Brahmin. So, but when Lord Balaram killed him, the sages said, "Oh, you've killed a Brahmin. You have to do atonement for that." And so they asked Lord Balaram that there was another demon there, and a demon called Balva, and Lord Balaram killed him. And then they said, "Now you've killed him, very good." He said, "Now you go on pilgrimage and go and visit the holy places, and this will be atonement for your killing of Rama Harshan Sutta." So he was not Sudra, but he was not pure Brahman. It was a mixed caste, you know. The husband and wife were of different castes. One was Kshatri, one was Brahman.
Okay, Maharaj, thank you.
Yes, any other question there?
Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Yes, Hare Krishna. Yes, you have a question? Someone?
Hare Krishna, Dhanu Pranam, Maharaj. As you mentioned, like this, the Das Avataras, they come from Chirodakshaya Vishnu, and those all include. So one is like Balram ji himself is one of the Dasavatar, in that, like we understand. The other is like Lord Narasimha, like we see in a past times of where this Jaya Vijaya, when they came here, so they were like Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha. So that time Lord Narasimha, first he appears. So, if he comes from Kshirodakshai Vishnu. So it means like the existence of Lord Narasimha Dev is not in spiritual abode, Maharaj.
Lord Narasimha Dev? Well, certainly Lord Narasimha Dev is in the spiritual abode. He's in the Vaikuntha, he has his own planet there, in the Vaikuntha. Right? Lord Narasimha Dev, Vishnu avatar. So he has his own abode in the spiritual world. At the same time, he can expand himself and he can appear also here in this world. And he can come. Just like Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is eternally in Goloka Vrindavan, but at the same time he can appear on this planet. He can to perform his pastimes, different ages, different times he will come. So the Lord has, he can expand himself in so many ways. We see when Lord Krishna was married, 16,108 wives, and Lord Krishna was with each of them at the same time. And he married each of them at the same time. And not only Lord Krishna, but even Vasudev and Devaki, they also expanded themselves so that they could attend the wedding, each of the weddings. So they're not of this material world. They're not limited. They have spiritual forms. And as spiritual forms, they can expand themselves also in different places, to appear in different places. But theoretically, we're told that this is how the Lord incarnates, that he comes through Kshirodakshayi Vishnu, that he is the origin. Before they come into this material world, they come through Kshirodakshayi Vishnu. Because Kshirodakshayi Vishnu, of course, he has his planet in the universe. Svetadvip is there, and the Lord can come there, and from there then he will come make his incarnation. We know when Lord Brahma and the demigods prayed, they wanted to know the world is overburdened with all the demonic kings, so they went to Svetadvip, they went to the shore anyway of the milk ocean, and they prayed, and then they got the instruction from Lord Vishnu. So Lord Vishnu is there on Svetadvip, and the different incarnations, it's not that they're coming exactly from Kshirodakshayi Vishnu, but they come there to Kshirodakshayi Vishnu's planet, and from there then they will come and appear in different places within the material world. That's how I understand the situation.
Yes, Maharaj. So, same way, Maharaj, like Lord Balram, he is the Vaibhav Prakash of Lord Sri Krishna, the direct expansion in the spiritual world. But here in Dasa Avatara, when Lord Balram is also there, so it means here in the material world, Lord Balram, he is coming from Kshirodakshayi Vishnu, and he is not that Lord which is like the first expansion of Lord Sri Krishna in the spiritual world.
Well, it will depend. Just like sometimes Lord Krishna comes, sometimes the Lord Krishna comes is coming from Kshirodakshayi Vishnu. Other times, it's directly the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Krishna, coming, the Swayam Bhagavan. We know in every age he comes, but only once in the day of Brahma does the Swayam Bhagavan Sri Krishna come. And similarly with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it's only once in the day of Brahma that Lord Chaitanya, the Supreme Lord, comes. Other times there's also the Yuga Dharma, and there's also Lord Chaitanya, but it's not the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It's another expansion of an expansion of the Lord coming.
Thank you so much, Maharaj.
Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you so much, Maharaj, for your time and clarifying our doubts also, Maharaj. Thank you so much. I'll request Amit Prabhu, you'd like to say a few words?
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Recording stopped.
Nirvatana Maharaj, thank you.